Code for Freedom Academy Charter School. It is Thursday, June 10th. Family, we are almost there. We almost at the end of the line for our cyber school for the whole school year. And then we're going to enjoy summer. Some of us are going to do Freedom Schools this summer. And then we're going to get back to it in September as we start our new school year. Family, let's all stand in the strong Aguilea and get ready for the pouring of libations, which we have permission to do by our elder, Dr. Mama. And to that, we say Ashe. We pour libations to the gift of life, laughter, love, and learning, Ashe. We pour to new beginnings, Ashe. And to the energy that woke us up this morning, Ashe. We pour libations to the continent of Africa, Ashe. To the many gifts that were given to the world by the continent of Africa, like agriculture, Ashe. Mathematics, Ashe. Astronomy, Ashe. Scripture, Ashe. Art and architecture, Ashe. We pour to the kingdoms that were named after, the nations that were named after, Ashe. To the Yoruba nation, Ashe. Congo nation, Ashe. The Kush nation. The Songhai nation, the Zulu nation, and the Maasai nation, Ashe. And we pour to kingdoms like Mali, Ashe, and Kemet, Ashe. And we pour to the kings and queens of these nations, Ashe. Kings like Mansa Musa, Ashe. Kings like Shaka, Ashe. Queen Nandi, Ashe. King Sunny Ali, Ashe. Queen Nzinga, Ashe. And we pour to the freedom fighters of these nations, like Steve Biko, Ashe, Patrice Lumumba, Ashe, Kwame Nkrumah, Ashe. And we pour to those who left the continent of Africa willingly, those who wanted to explore. We were the original explorers. Africans were the original explorers. Explorers that look like you. And they come from Africa, Ashe, and they gave humanity to the world, Ashe. So those who weren't afraid to climb the mountains and cross the seas, we pour to them, Ashe. And we pour to those who remained on the continent of Africa and helped build great cities that lasted for thousands of years, Ashe. And we pour to those who were taken from their land against their will, the Ma'afa, Ashe, the Middle Passage, Ashe, and the millions of lives that were lost, Ashe. And we pour to the Americas, North America, Central America, South America, and the Caribbean, Ashe. And the kingdoms that were here for so long before they were discovered. The Mayas, the Incas, the Tainos, the Aztecs, the Olmecs, Ashe. And we pour to those who crossed the seas enslaved on ships. The Middle Passage, those who survived the Middle Passage, those from whom we descend, Ashe. And we pour to the freedom fighters of the New World, freedom fighters like Toussaint Louverture, excuse me, and like Nat Turner, Ashe, Pedro Albizu Campos, Ashe, Medgar Evers, Ashe, Harriet Tubman, Ashe, Marcus Garvey, Ashe, Malcolm X, Ashe, and Martin Luther King, Ashe, and to the many freedom fighters, Ashe. And we pour to the institutions that teach us about our history, teach us about our great leaders, our kingdoms, our greatness, the greatness that we come from, and also teach us about our current struggles and teach us about our obstacles in order for us to move forward. And to those institutions, we pour, Ashe, the HBCUs, Sankofa Freedom Academy Charter School, Imhotep, and the Freedom Schools Movement, Ashe. And we pour to the scholars, those who are learning about our history and those who are building our circle, Ashe. That is you, scholars. And to our personal ancestors, those who mentor us or mentored us, those who built the foundation for our families, Ashe. And family, we pour to the lives that were lost, that were taken by the injustices of our country and the world. We pour to the lives of George Floyd, Amadou Diallo, Breonna Taylor, Oscar Grant, Trayvon Martin, and to the many, many, many lives that were taken unjustly. And to them we say Ashe. And we pour to the babies and the babies' babies and those who are going to come and complete our circle, Ashe. And lastly, we pour it to the ancestors in hopes that they receive and accept this libation. Ashe, ashe, ashe. And family, the principle of the month is, and that means, yes, the principle of the month is Imani, and that means faith. And I have faith that we are all going to enjoy this summer and be safe this summer. And I have faith that many of you are still watching Morning Circle, as you should. And part of the reason is because I want to do another read aloud. Today, I would like to share a read aloud with you that was inspired by the Zulu Nation yesterday, or 2 days ago, excuse me, in their ceremony, their move up ceremony. They were talking about roses and thorns, and some of these scholars were saying that they would like to leave their talkativeness behind, and they mentioned that they may have been troublemakers and things like that. And to those scholars, I like to say, yes, it is good to leave your talkativeness outside of the classroom when it is time to learn. And yes, we don't want to start trouble. However, we are able to be talkative when it is time to be talkative. And as long as we control that talkativeness can lead. That talkativeness can inspire. That talkativeness can bring change. And maybe it is not considered troublemaking, but stirring up emotions and provoking thought. That is another way that we can view our troublemaking tendencies. But we'll talk more about that because I would like to share a story of Thurgood Marshall. And listen to the words of the story. And I hope that that gives you a little perspective on how we could use our energies in a good way. Again, family, the story is about Thurgood Marshall. Check it out, and we'll talk more on the other side. All right.
Little Leaders, Exceptional Men in Black History by Vashti Harrison. Today's leader, Thurgood Marshall. 1908 to 1993, Supreme Court Justice. Thurgood, later shortened to Thurgood, was a naturally argumentative boy and a bit of a troublemaker. His punishment for talking too much was to memorize the U.S. Constitution, which probably wasn't the worst thing for him, considering that one day he would become one of the world's leading constitutional scholars. By the time he applied to college, Thurgood knew he wanted to be a lawyer. He hoped to attend the University of Maryland School of Law, but couldn't because he was black. The anger and frustration about that instilled in him a deep desire for justice and equality. Instead, he earned his law degree from the historically black college, Howard University. Not long after graduation in 1933, Thurgood began working with his mentor, Charles Houston, for the NAACP. He wanted to help fight for civil rights. Their major goal was to overturn the U.S. Supreme Court ruling that segregation was legal if the segregated facilities were separate but equal. Black people in America knew that their facilities were nowhere near equal and that they had nothing close to the same opportunities as white people. Thurgood had proof, UMD School of Law. He and Charles made the case to Maryland state courts that in order to uphold a separate but equal law, UMD would need to have a second school that admitted black students. In 1936, they won. It was the first in a long line they brought to take down legal segregation. Then, in 1954, Thurgood brought the case of Brown versus the Board of Education of Topeka to the U.S. Supreme Court. It was the landmark ruling that would lead to the end of legal segregation in the country. In 1967, Thurgood was appointed as an associate justice to the U.S. Supreme Court. He would be the first African-American justice. In his long career, he was well known for his constitutional knowledge and even helped the United Nations draft the constitutions for newly formed countries Ghana and present-day Tanzania. Thurgood spent so much of his life fighting for justice. It was a long road, but he never lost hope.
Ashe. And so, family, before we move on, I would like to apologize for yesterday's morning circle. Something occurred that has never occurred before, and there was an overlap in voices. And it was brought to my attention by a parent, and I appreciate that parent for reaching out to me, because when I posted it, I didn't hear the overlapping in voices. I don't know what happened. And of course, family, this is my first time actually doing things on virtually like this. And you know, we're gonna run into mistakes and everything, and I hope that you guys forgive me for that. But yesterday, the word of the day was Zulu. And that was in honor of our Zulu nation. So I hope that didn't deter you to keeping on watching, because I did have a nice video at the end of the video in honor of the Zulu nation and their success. So again, my apologies. I'll try not to let that happen again. I definitely won't let it happen this time. But anyway, moving forward, I also forgot to mention a birthday, which I'm going to recognize today. But back to our story about Thurgood Marshall. In the story, it talked about that he was a bit of a troublemaker, and he was very talkative. And as one of his punishments, his redirections, was to read the U.S. Constitution. And that actually built his knowledge about law and the constitutional rights of Americans. And that led him to becoming a scholar in human rights and court laws. And so he became a trailblazer. He actually broke down barriers and changed laws, giving Black people more rights than they had ever had in American history. And he became one of the top leaders in civil rights. And so when we talk about the things that we are critical on ourselves, or talk about these labels that are placed on us even by us adults, we have to consider how we can change these things and use them with power. So if you think that you're talkative, use that talkativeness, as I do in my morning circles, in a good way, in a leading way. And if you consider yourself, or if you may have been called, a troublemaker, take that energy to provoke thought. Because sometimes when you provoke thought, when you make somebody think or make a people think differently from how they usually think, they might consider that trouble at first. And once you use your talkativeness to educate and lead, you change people's perspectives, you change ideas, you change laws, and you can change the world. So I hope that that story from one of our books of the month, Little Leaders, can inspire some of you, if not all of you, to look at yourself and maybe just redirect some of the things that you may not think are right, because we're all learning and we're all growing. Even someone as old as myself am always growing and learning something new. So I hope this story inspired you. And family, the word of the day is scholar. It was a word used in the book. That is what Thurgood Marshall was. And this is what we call you, scholars. What does the word scholar mean to you? It has so many definitions, including the way that we use it as Sankofa. You are scholars. We use it as a substitute for the word student or pupil, because you are constantly learning and you will continue to learn. A college professor can be considered a scholar, or is considered a scholar. I myself, I study a lot, and therefore I can consider myself a scholar. But what does scholar mean to you? Again, family, the word of the day is scholar. So comment down below what your thoughts of the book were, my message, what did that mean to you, and what does the word scholar mean to you? Family, for our recognitions, I want to do a little something different. I want to recognize the scholars that are going to be celebrating their birthdays this month and next month, because we're not going to get to celebrate everybody's birthday, and I want to make sure that we recognize these scholars. And so first and foremost, I would like to recognize a brother that we all know and love, a brother that has always been there to support us as a community, as a institution, as an institution, and that is Brother Jose. Brother Jose's birthday was yesterday, and I want to send a special shout out to him. Brother, happy birthday. I hope you had a great birthday. So shout out to Brother Jose. On June 8th, it was the birthday of Masai Cunningham from 4A. Next week, on June 16th, Aria Gordon from 1A will be celebrating her birthday. And from the Kush Nation on June 19th, that will be Isaiah Thomas's birthday. And from the Kush Nation as well on June 20th, our twins, the Turner sisters, Jade Turner will be celebrating her birthday as well as Jaylise Turner. And that will be on June 20th. On June 22nd, from the Congo Nation, Jahan Hicks will be celebrating his birthday. Shout out to Jahan. On June 27th, Josiah Childs will be celebrating his birthday. So shout out to you, Josiah. On June 28th, from the Zulu Nation, London Hightower will be celebrating her birthday. And now we're moving into July. On July 1st, Satya Cipriani, Sunshine, will be celebrating her birthday. Again, that was Sati. On July 1st, Evelyn Leon will be celebrating her birthday as well, from the Kush Nation, Evelyn, on July 1st. From the Yoruba Nation, well, now Congo Nation, next year, is Siraj Deitches, who will be celebrating his birthday on July 2nd. Jenalise from the Kush Nation, from the Congo Nation, she will be in the Kush Nation. Jenalise Rodriguez will be celebrating her birthday on July 4th. From the Kush Nation, moving on to the Songhai Nation, on July 8th, Chase Williams will be celebrating his birthday. From the Zulu Nation, we're now moving on to the Dogon Nation. Going to the fifth grade, Zane Hayes will be celebrating his birthday on July 12th. On July 13th, we have from 1A, Jador Ford will be celebrating her birthday. Also from the Zulu Nation, we're moving into the middle school world, celebrating his birthday on July 13th, will be Jason Henderson. Also from the Zulu Nation, well, now middle school, celebrating his birthday on July 14th, will be Zara Carter. And from the Congo Nation, celebrating her birthday on July 16th, will be Zoe Thomas. And also from the Zulu Nation, a lot of Zulu middle schoolers now celebrating their birthday on July 22nd. Tajir Odin will be celebrating his birthday. And from the now Congo Nation, well, she was in the Yoruba Nation celebrating her birthday on July 23rd, will be Janaya Williams. So shout out to Janaya. And from the Songhai Nation celebrating her birthday on July 24th, will be Savannah Henderson. All right. And another set of twins celebrating their birthdays on July 25th. That will be the Jones twins, Aubrey Jones and Zaria Jones. They will be celebrating the birthdays on July 25th. From the Kush Nation, on July 26th, we'll be celebrating her birthday. That will be Abini Williams. So shout out to Abini. And from another now middle schooler, he will be celebrating his birthday on July 26th, and that is Dennis Holmes. Dennis Holmes will be celebrating. Also from the Songhai Nation, celebrating on July 28th, that is Malaya Taylor. She will be celebrating her birthday. And from the Zulu Nation again, well, middle school, I keep messing that up. On July 28th, Anaya Hayes will be celebrating her birthday. And on July 30th, from the Congo Nation, will be Bryce Williams. He will be celebrating his birthday. From the Kush Nation on July 30th as well, we'll be celebrating Wahaj Butler will be celebrating his birthday on July 30th. And on July 30th as well, from the Songhai Nation, now moving on to the Zulu Nation, will be Safir Jefferson. So those were a lot of names, a lot of scholars celebrating their birthdays. And I know that there will be scholars in August who will be celebrating birthdays. And we are going to shout you out when we return to school in September. And so, family, if you are celebrating a birthday this summer, a happy birthday, a happy born day, a happy birthday to you. And I'm going to allow Stevie just to sing. I'm sure you already heard him sing it, but I want to hear him sing it again. Sing it, Stevie.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Oh, man. So, family, if you are celebrating a birthday today, yesterday, the rest of the summer, have a safe and happy birthday. Family, tomorrow I'm going to have a nice little video for all of you with some pictures that facilitators sent to me, some pictures that I have that I've taken throughout the year. And I hope you guys enjoy that. Today I wanted to make sure that I continued with the read aloud. And I wanted to thank you all for inspiring me to continue to do this. And I want to send a special shout out to the middle school, to Brother Darius, who throughout all of this work, this brother has been studying to become a doctor. So probably by next year, we will be calling Brother Darius Dr. Darius. So special shout out to Brother Darius, because he has been doing this work while studying for his doctorate degree. Again, he is a scholar. He is the word of the day, scholar. A special shout out to Brother Darius for his hard work and continuing to inspire me as a dean and as a scholar. I want to study to get my doctorate degree, and he showed me that it is possible with hard work and dedication. So shout out to you, Brother Darius, and shout out to the middle school for their move up day this week. I truly am proud of all of you, all of the red shirts, for their hard work. And so shout out to Brother Darius. Thank you, brother. And on Friday will be the move up day for, or the graduation for, our upper school. So shout out to the upper school, Dr. Ma'at, who continues to inspire me as well. And shout out to Sister Tamika and the staff in the upper school for their hard work. And so, family, let's continue to do our work. Make sure that you are signing in to sfacs.us and clicking on that cyberlink and continuing to turn in your work. On Monday, we are having parents bring in their Chromebooks, your Chromebooks, and that would finish off our school year. And so, family, for our moment of silence, I'm jumping ahead. For our moment of silence, let's think about how we are going to grow this summer, and how we are going to continue our reading this summer, and how we are going to continue being scholars, and be proud of ourselves that we've earned our summer break. We've earned chill time, just a little bit. I know you got work to do and summer work to do, but let's think about how we are going to spend our summer and reward ourselves for the hard work that we have accomplished. Let's think about that for our moment of silence. And our moment of silence begins now. Ashe. So, family, enjoy the rest of your day. Again, make sure you get your work done. And I will see you tomorrow for our very special Friday morning circle as we, you know, close out the school year. I'll see you tomorrow. Peace. Love you. Bye-bye.
More Jack in the building. Tattoo.